Of course, I don't need to tell everyone, we came here last season and won by a goal to nil. Wouldn't I love to see County do that tonight, as the two teams are now coming out onto the pitch. Lee Evans wears the number 36 shirt tonight, making his debut. Good luck to the youngster. I'm sure everyone listening to iRadio City Radio will wish him the same. This is Cambridge United versus Newport County. This is Blue Square Bet Premier action, live as it happens. We are away and the ball is played out to the far side, and already County get the ball towards the corner flag, and that will surely be ushered out for a goal kick. As Rogers throws it in to Knights, turns, plays the ball down. It's a very, very good ball played into the channel here to Jarvis, who controls it neatly, and he's looking for options. Ball to Beatsman, he's taking it into the box, he shoots. As Sandell throws the ball in to the edge of the area, back out it comes. Sandell takes the ball from the edge of the area, steps neatly inside, chips it to the far post, but back out it comes the other side. Gash touches the ball on, and there's something on here for Cambridge. Ball is with Thorpe on the side, and it's well headed out there by Hughes, but the danger's not over. County getting bodies in, and they do manage to clear it with Hughes now. Plenty of bodies in the box. In comes the corner kick. It's a beauty, but it's headed out, and it's still not cleared, but it's going to be now as the ball is played out. And that's an absolute beautiful ball out to the far side, and I can see Rogers chasing over to that far side. It's two, County have got three players back now, and Rogers has held the player up so well, because County were badly stretched and they've now won the ball back. Well played, Paul Rogers. He went from right back to left back and just managed to hold them up enough, because the County were stretched, but they managed to hold them up. But it's the home side who are still on the ball, and the ball is on that far side, and it's played centrally into midfield. It's with Jarvis. Jarvis transfers the ball to Jennings. He's got 10 yards to be able to run at County. Jarvis closes him down. He plays it to Dorkin. Dorkin steps inside. Ramon Rose takes it into the box. It's danger, and it's gone through Wynn Thompson and into the net, and Cambridge United have the lead. It's a soft goal. It's 24 minutes, and it's Dorkin who got through, and it's Cambridge United 1, Newport County 0 in the 24th minute. After 24 minutes, the goal came here at the Abbey Stadium as the corner kick comes in. It's a good one, and it's there, is it? No, it's disallowed. The referee has disallowed it. The ball was in. It was an absolute beautiful corner kick, but unfortunately, the goal is disallowed. Naisbitt outside his area is going to kick it, right footed, halfway inside his own half now. In fact, makes so much ground, plays the ball forward, and the ball is missed by two or three players, and County are in danger here because there are Cambridge players. The ball is coming in the other way, and they had a real chance to make it 2-0. There were two players 2 yards out who were the strikers, Gash and Pugh, and somehow they have contrived to miss an easier chance than the one that they have scored. Thompson then will take this. County throwing plenty of bodies forward as he takes it. It's a good one from Glenn Thompson. Forward it goes, and bodies going in there. County appeal for handball, not given. Jarvis won the ball. Ball is played beautifully by Evans to Knights on the edge of the area. Dal Knights steps outside, plays it to Evans. Evans plays the ball to Sandell, who's wide on the left-hand side. Sandell takes the ball to the line, crosses it inside, straight into Naisbitt's arms. So this will probably be the last attack. Dal Knights is going to chip it forward. He does chip it forward. Warren goes for it. It comes out. And Buchanan on the edge of the area turns the ball out on that far side. Ramon Rose, it plays the ball in, but Naisbitt gathers it quite easily. And there's the referee's whistle for half-time. It's Cambridge United 1, Newport County 0. We'll be back with you for the second half. Back to you in the studio, George. So it's a poor goal from County's perspective to give away. They've got it all to do. They've got 45 minutes and we are underway. Rogers throws it across to Andrew Hughes. He in turn touches it to Sandell in the left-back position tonight. Plays the ball then forward to Ramon Rose, steps neatly inside, plays a good-looking ball to Jake Harris. Jake Harris to our left-hand side, steps beautifully inside, crosses it in low, and my goodness me, Wild almost got a touch to it, and if it come off him, it could have been an own goal. As Dorkin takes the ball, he's being allowed to carry it. He's carrying it forever and ever, and the ball is now on that far side. In comes the ball, played neatly inside. and County have some more defending to do. They get numbers in, but there's going to be a shot. It comes in, and it's wide of the post there. But Sandell throws the ball into the box, but it's headed out, but it's miscued. But in comes a shot, and the goalkeeper there takes it. It was Ramon Rose. As the ball is thrown in, the youngster touches the ball to Sandell. Sandell takes a touch, plays the ball inside, looking for Jarvis. Jarvis touches the ball to Ramon Rose. Ramon Rose plays the ball into this channel. He's looking for the runner, Porter. Porter plays the ball inside, but the ball comes out as far as Rose. Rose shoots, and it's wide of the far post. Has time to play the ball across to Sandell. As I said, playing left back tonight. Chips the ball forward. Jake Harris heads the ball forward. Porter does very well. Jake Harris gets the ball forward. And a little bit of a mix-up there, but the goalkeeper just about gathers the ball. It's almost level with the edge of the area as Sandell throws it long into the box. It's headed forward, and County have got the ball as they look to Warren plays the ball back. Ramon Rose, snapshot, wide of the near post. Free kick is taken. It goes long to the far side. Ball is headed backwards, but it's wide by Nat Jarvis, 1,815, so it's less than 2,000 as we predicted, as Down Knights plays a great-looking ball forward onto that far side. The youngster is in. It's Jake Harris. He transfers the ball across, but the defender got a touch on it as the ball was going to be with Ramon Rose. Harris did awfully well, but the ball is being transferred to Dorkin on that far side, and they're really breaking forward in numbers. Now it's with Berry, and Jake Harris did awfully well. He got the ball forward. It's still in the County half on that far side. The ball is being transferred in. A good 1-2 coming in, and County are backing off. In comes the shot. It hits the post, and County really have escaped a second goal, and they're now mounting their own attack as the ball is played in to Jake Harris. Jake Harris, he's got Darryl Knight, and Darryl Knight has played in. They've got two in the box. In comes the cross, and the centre-back headers it out. And this really is end-to-end stuff the last couple of minutes. But the ball is thrown in now for County. Back out to the far post, and oh, it comes out the other way. It's now a corner kick to County as they mount their pressure. County have the corner kick as the corner is swung in, but it's headed out by the big centre-back, but only as far as Knight. Ball is on the far side with Sandell. He's going to swing this ball in. More bodies going in there. Keeper elects the punch. Out it goes. But Sandell's going to be able to gather this ball just inside. But there's a bit of a clash there, and County have a player on the floor. I think it may be Warren. I'm not absolutely certain. And Naisbitt is going to kick this right-footed high above the stands. Into the night sky it goes, down it comes. Ball is headed forward, and County in trouble. The shot comes in, but it was dealt with, fortunately, by Thompson at his near post. It was a shot from Gash. He had a chance there, and I think that Warren is going to be coming off. He is. We're halfway through this second half, and Gary Wadron disconsolately trudges off towards the touchline. Hatswell is now on in the centre of the defence. He's going to get his second run out in a few days. And the ball is transferred to Kevin Roberts right in front of us. Plays the ball forward, looking for the run of Gash. Comes off his and does well. And he's evaded Hughes. He's into the box. He squares it. But it's a poor one. And Wayne Hatswell to the rescue. And Jackson is on as the free kick is taken. It goes long to the far post. And Gash so nearly got on the end of it. And he goes out for a goal kick. And Thompson will take the goal kick. Sandell, who's got the captain's armband, and Sandell going forward, going well forward, steps inside, plays the ball inside, as it's now played by Evans to Jake Reed. Jake Reed touches the ball to the far side. It's now with Jarvis. Jarvis plays it in. It comes off two or three players. It's as far as Rose. Rose chips the ball in to the far side, but back out it comes, and it's... Oh, it's the shot there from the youngster, Lee Evans, is deflected for a corner kick. As County mount pressure here with just under 16 minutes left, in comes the corner kick. It's headed clear at the far post. Sorry, at the near post as the home side gather it, but County win it back. Forward it goes, and we're trying to see who it is on that far side. It's with Jake Reed. Oh, they just about get the tackle in the centre-back, and the goalkeeper gathers it. He was about to pull the trigger. In fact, it's going to be a goal kick, because the linesman has deemed it. It did go out. It won't be a throw-in, it's a goal kick. And Glenn Thompson will take it, and Jez George is really quite upset by it, the Cambridge United manager, as the goal kick is taken. It's with Hughes, hurriedly plays it forward, left-footed. And in fact, Ramon Rose has got the forward, he's played into the box and it's just touched out. And in fact, County so nearly got the ball forward. And it's a penalty for handball, and County have a penalty. It's handball, it's drama. County have a penalty for handball. 85 minutes gone, and it's a penalty to County. We have 5 minutes left, and this really is precious moments for Newport County. It is drama at the Abbey Stadium. It's for handball. It's Sandell who's going to take it. It's Sandell against Naisbitt. Can he put County level? This is drama. My heart is in my mouth. It's there! It's a goal! And it is Sandell who has buried it into the top corner. And County have their equaliser. It's given us handball. It is 85 minutes. The fans to my left-hand side are celebrating. But County must stand firm for these final 5 minutes, plus any stoppage time. It's transferred to Roberts. Roberts plays the ball to the far side, as Hatswell gets ahead on it, but he doesn't get distance. And again, it's with Tiriaki. And County get the ball forward, get the ball out of defence. County must keep their shape, keep the balance, keep the discipline in these last 2 minutes and see this out for what would be a smashing draw. But they've still got defending to do, as the substitute defender Hudson plays it forward deep into County territory, and they've got defended. Tiriaki, on his right across the face of the goal. If someone would have been in there, that would have been curtains for County. The ball is played forward somehow to Jake Reed, but Jake Reed is going to win this ball. But now the ball is played over the top, just about the face. Jake Harris and the home side are going forward. This is end-to-end stuff. The ball is now with 18, who is Berry. Ball is played forward to this side. It's headed by Sandell, but the home side in the shape of Roberts get it forward to Tiriaki. The cross comes in. They have to defend it. Hatswell does brilliantly at the near post to defend it. Naisbitt is in a hurry. He plays it out to Jennings, who's got the captain's armband on. He plays the ball forward centrally, and County still look for this ball, but they haven't got it. It's the home side who've got it. As Berry turns, twists and turns, ball is on the far side. It's now with Dorkin. Dorkin takes the ball. He's going to be able to cross this, but Rogers gets a foot to it, and Hatswell gets it out into touch. The long throw-in, barely 30 seconds plus stoppage time. I'm hoarse. Can we get a point? Rob Phillips is stood, so's Andy Legg to my left-hand side. In comes the long throw, it goes. Wayne Hatswell wins it, back out it comes, back it comes, it's touched into the box. Glenn Thompson must win it, punches it out, back it comes the other way, and surely the shot will come in. It's wide of the far post. And they're being told to calm down and take it now and see this game out. Back it comes the other way. Hatswell stands firm. Hughes does beautifully, brilliantly by Andrew Hughes to Sandell. Plays it forward. Ramon Rose touches the ball forward to Jake Reed. Off his chest, takes the ball forward. Does brilliantly, takes the ball into the box. And can he get a corner kick? No, he can't. It's a goal kick which the referee got right. Jake is not 10 yards, but the ball is played forward by Roberts to the far side. It's headed out by that far side, but it's only as far as Dorkin is touched in. They're going to have to deal with this cross. It's crossed in, but it's out, and it's a goal kick. The danger is now over. 2 minutes of stoppage time played. 120 seconds left. Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear. What it is to be a Newport County supporter. 30 seconds left. Thompson takes it right-footed. Forward it goes. Harris, he can't win it in the air. Back it comes the other way. Lee Evans goes for it. Ball is touched in. Ball is played forward towards the edge of the area. Ball is headed out. Well played. It's now hit forward. It's with Jake Reed. Jake Reed touches it. Will he be able to play the ball forward? He does. And Jake Harris is going to be onto this. Jake Harris takes it towards the corner flag. Does brilliantly, Jake Harris. Hold it, Jake. Hold it. Try and win a corner. He gets through in the area. And the referee has given a free kick to County. Jake Harris appeals that he got past the two players. He got into the box. The referee blows for the free kick. And Harris was about to pass the ball. And that could have ended up in a drama and could have ended up with a dramatic winner. And the referee is blown up for the free kick. Mystifying. This is drama. The free kick will come in. The referee will blow his whistle. In it goes. It goes long to the far post. It's headed across. Hughes heads it to the far post. It comes back out and to this far side. There's the referee's whistle for the end of the match. It's a valuable point for County here tonight. It's finished Cambridge United 1, Newport County 1 for a very exciting... Oh dear, Abbey Stadium is back to you in the studio, George. Good night to you all.
Well, just in controversy at the end, but you deserve that point, didn't you?
I think reflection. I think we certainly deserved the point. Not sure whether or not we've done enough to win the game. Disappointed with the goal we conceded, but you know, I thought the response in the second half, the tempo we played at, was what I expected of us first half. But you know, circumstances as they were, and reflection of it, I think we'd have settled for a point before the game.
Your view of the penalty?
I couldn't really see. I mean, it's a decision. I spoke with the ref, you know, at half time because I felt that we'd had a goal taken off us from no fault of a player other than the goalkeeper getting in the wrong position and pulling our player out of the way.
And a confident penalty.
Yeah, dispatched it very well. He asked me before the game, could he take him? Perhaps he felt that there was one coming. It showed good nerve, good head. You know, I expect that from Sands. He's done very well since he's been here, and you know, probably wasn't his best game. He's been out for a while, and with the trophies, missed a lot of football, but you know, he plugged away tonight.
How big is the point after what happened on Saturday, would you say?
Well, regardless of Saturday, I think it was a big point in terms of the way the results went tonight. It's another point to safety, and that's what we need to keep doing. You know, we knew we had two away games here tonight and one Saturday, and you know, as long as we keep picking up points, then we're going to be okay. But that was a big point.
And you lost Gary Warren. How bad is he?
Gary being Gary, he probably shouldn't have played tonight. You know, he took a bad knock on Saturday. That's the character of the guy. He's an immense person, and you know, on and off the field. And you know, he probably shouldn't have played tonight. But he's rolled it again. But you know, no, Gary, you put yourself for Saturday, and they'd be fit. But yeah, no, we'll have to assess that one. We might have to bring a defender in before Thursday because we are light. We're playing our super sub, Wayne Atzerodt, at the minute, at 49 years old. It's not great.
One in the pipeline, maybe?
Well, I'll have to go to work tomorrow. I mean, we've made some inquiries over the last 24, 48 hours, and hopefully we can bring someone in before Thursday.
You talk about super sub. Jake Harris makes things happen, doesn't he, again?
Well, yeah, I mean, I thought it wasn't going to be our night because when balls roll like that to him in the box, you expect him to score, and the guy got a good interception. But yeah, listen, the boy's got a big future. I said that. Whether or not he's ready to make an impact from the start, I'm not sure. But yeah, again, he's come on and made an impact in the game.
Talk about the missing players. How many would you expect to have back for Saturday?
All of them. Yeah, I mean, Sam was away with personal reasons. Lee Minsell has served his third match suspension now. Pipey will be fit. I expect them all to be okay. Ryan Charles is now eligible, so that's good. We've got four big players back for Saturday, which is a massive boost for us.
Yeah, and they're all big games, but they're down with you. It's a game you need to get something from again.
They're all big games. I said to the boys before the game, we've got 10 cup finals. And another one again Saturday, and another eight after that. They're all as big as they are. I mean, we always want to make sure that we don't get beat by the people around us, and you know, that's what we aim to do on Saturday.